So directed energy, basically laser beams. All the services are interested in them. They've been interested in them for decades, going back before the technology was even available. In the most recent years, we've seen a lot of directed energy or laser projects geared at counter-drone options. You know, the Army was equipping 5-kilowatt, 10-kilowatt, and larger and higher, more powerful lasers on Stryker combat vehicles for testing in Europe and, of course, here in the continental United States. The Air Force did a 2018 counter-drone laser rodeo in White Sands missile range, where they tried a whole bunch of different options from vehicle to stationary mounted lasers to take out drones. That's pretty well known, but there's some new projects coming up that are quite interesting for the Navy and the Air Force that are pretty big. First one up is Thor, not the mythical Norse god of thunder nor the Marvel Avenger character, but actually the tactical high-powered operational responder. It's a prototype piece of equipment from the Air Force Research Laboratory that is essentially geared toward hitting multiple targets, sometimes simultaneously. That item is a laser, essentially, that would hit all kinds of drones, different ranges, different powers, different altitudes. It's obviously a prototype, so it's going to take a little while to get it off the ground, but it could help solve that big drone swarm problem that a lot of strategists seem to be concerned with. Next one's another Air Force project, pretty interesting, pretty sci-fi, and I'm not going to rely on memory here, I'm going to read the acronym itself. It is the Space Solar Powered Incremental Development and Research Project, or SPIDER. You know, they have a sub-project I'm not even going to try to spell out called Arachne. You get the theme. But essentially what it does is it takes solar power, you know, two satellites that are going to collect that energy and then beam that energy through RF frequency to a forward operating base that will then collect it, transfer it back into power. So instead of having generators, convoys, and all the fuel that you would need for that, you literally are getting your energy from the sun through a satellite. The next one is from the Navy. It is the Directed Energy Systems Integration Lab. Now, the lab broke ground earlier this year and is scheduled to open in December. It's essentially a lab built entirely around figuring out how to put lasers on ships, whether that's to hit drones, use weapons against other ships, maybe lasers for communications. There's all kinds of options. And this lab is actually going to have about a 36,000 square mile range for testing, and it's going to be testing all these different ideas, all these different concepts for the Navy. So the Air Force is looking at space. Air Force is looking at counter-drone, the other services are doing the same, mounting stuff on vehicles. So the technology is finally catching up with the science fiction, and there's options now for lasers across the military services. So a lot of them still in prototype phase, but we'll see what's going to happen. This has been Todd South of Military Times.